no blooming Uncle Jimmy's pool room. It's Uncle Jimmy's pool room. It's Uncle Jimmy's pool room.
Welcome to Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room for another week, episode 9, in a studio, Brody Holman.
Our studio, we are moving up in the world. I'm excited, Robbo.
Who would have thunk we would got this good? Look at all these photos around, nice pool table. Harry Kuehl, the man. You know Harry Kuehl's got a lot of tattoos, don't you?
He does have a lot of tattoos.
You know what I mean, don't you? Remember this?
My boys are going that well. The Pies are chock full of confidence. I reckon they could beat anyone, anytime, any day.
Any place.
Does not matter, Robbo. And let me tell you, if they lose in the next 10 weeks, I will do anything you want me to do.
If they lose, I want you to get a tattoo of Uncle Jimmy's pool room on your foot.
Oh, come on, seriously.
Oh, you said anything.
Okay, I'll do it, but only because I know they will not lose a game for the next 10 weeks.
Well, there you have it, Dutchie. You said it, now you got to do it.
I will do it. I don't want to do it. We're very unlucky. Pendle should have had that goal, Robbo. Why the foot?
Nah, the foot because it's the most painful part of the body to get done.
Enough of tattoos. I'm sick of talking about it. Let's get on with it. We've got a massive show. We've got Jared Blair, Collingwood superstar and midget, and we've got his cousin on as well, Natalie Blair. She's also a movie star, Robbo.
Natalie Blair, yes, it's a Blair affair on Uncle Jimmy's. But before we get to those, I want to introduce the interview of the year for us. It doesn't get any better. Mark Chopper Reed. We've got to get him up first, too, because I know he's logging in, and if he doesn't get up first, I might get into trouble. Watch this. Well, Brody, there's been big moments in my life, huge ones, where I got drafted to Melbourne.
Yes.
No doubt when you got drafted to Collingwood, played in the grand final in 2000, but nothing comes close to this moment right here. A chance on Uncle Jimmy's pool room to interview the great Mark Chopper Reed. How are you, Chop?
Chopper. Looking sick with the sunnies.
Looking real good, mate.
And black and white sunnies. Have a look at that.
He's a great Collingwood man. Is that true, Chop?
He's a great Collingwood man. Now,
you're friend of Eddie McGuire's.
Yeah. You like Eddie, do you?
Yeah, he's a good bloke.
He's a good man. Yeah. Yeah. Of course, everyone's nice to you, though, Chop. Let's be honest.
Eddie's a specially nice person.
Now, we're on set here, Brody, and Chop. We're on set of the new movie that Chop is starring as himself in. It's called Groomless Bride. It's going to be out next August.
I'm not playing myself. I'm playing a bikey called Alan.
Well,
bikey called Alan.
Bikey called Alan.
I'll say that. Hello, little girl. Hello.
Hello, Shazzy.
Hello, Shazzy.
Eric Banner. Should take him out and shoot him. Here's my $1 million, Eric. What's his name? Michael Gudinski. Where's me money?
Michael Gudinski.
I wouldn't mind getting paid for that buddy movie.
Didn't get any retribution at all, mate.
He's looking for you, Mike. You better be careful. I remember back in the day, she reminds me of when I first came to Collingwood, because Chris Tarrant and I reckon we watched it 4 or 5 times together, and we used to get on the cans and watch a bit of Chopper. It was one of the greatest movies I've ever seen. But tell us about your character, a little bit more depth about the character in this movie.
I'm playing a bikie that's suffering from brain damage, which isn't hard for me.
Robbo can relate to that.
I'm lying in bed, and these couple of male nurses are coming towards me with, they want to give me a sponge bath.
Yeah.
And there's a scene of me sitting in the toilet writing the stuff on the wall, but I've got no clothes on.
Yeah.
They're not going to do it behind the... And they're not coming from under the
coming from behind, no way.
They're coming front on, so that's all right.
And is acting a part of your life now? Is this going to be a regular thing?
I've got another movie after this. Some crime thing, you know.
Yeah.
El Rama.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So there's plenty going on for Chop at the moment.
Yeah, you know, a bit of acting.
And you don't get down
I've got another book coming out too.
Another book?
Pam McMillan's publishing it.
Another bestseller?
Road to Nowhere, it'll be a bestseller.
Can you just say to the camera, you know, written a bestseller and I can't even bloody spell?
I've written a bestseller and I can't even bloody spell. Where's
me
money, Eric?
Look out, Eric. I swear to God, mate, stay in the States.
You're a Collingwood boy through and through, though, aren't you?
I mean,
you're still living in Collingwood. How long have you lived there now?
Oh, you know, for years.
Yeah. And you used to get to the Vic Park games in the old days.
Yeah.
Were you one of the blokes that was spitting and throwing beer bottles on the island?
Don't do that stuff.
No. I used to carry a handgun with me, though. I can't do that anymore.
About down to the MCG. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Chopper, thanks for joining us on Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room. We really appreciate your time.
Thanks for coming on, mate. We do appreciate it.
He was. Thanks,
Chopper.
No, he was.
Thanks, mate. They hear that from the Chop Man, Uncle Chop Chop.
You've got it all.
What about Robbo? What do you think of him?
No, he's all right.
Yes.
Doesn't ever play for Collingwood.
I should have. There you go. Thanks very much.
Cheers, buddy.
Uncle Chop Chop. Robbo, what do you reckon? He loved the Dutch, didn't he?
Hey? Oh, everybody loved the Dutch. Everybody loves the Dutch, too. Yeah, yeah. Hey, it's amazing what you can do if you just drop the name Uncle Jim. We get the best interview.
Uncle Chop Chop. It doesn't get any bigger than that.
Speaking of great interviews, we've got a young bloke next to us. To my right, Jared Blair from the Collingwood Football Club. How are you, mate?
Hey, boys.
Larry Dog.
Yeah. Now, Collingwood doing some nice things. Obviously, a loss. Do you know? Have you ever felt a loss before at Collingwood? I don't think you ever have you?
That was only my second one, mate.
Second one?
Not too used to it, and I didn't really like it.
Now, were you around the club when this joker was around?
No, I didn't, mate.
Poisoning the place.
I've heard, I've heard a lot of stories, good or bad, I don't know. They're
direct correlation with Collingwood doing well as soon as Brody left, you know that, don't you?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Oh, well, I think I started what's evolving now, don't you reckon?
Yeah, I reckon.
Larry, what do you reckon?
I think the old mirrors on the glass too were put in because of this point.
I think if I've had impact in one thing and one thing only, the boys are all having solariums right now, let me tell you. Now, Larry, you're the leading goal kicker after round two, and you know, you've slowed down a little bit, but you're still going pretty well. You know, what do you make of your year? I mean, it's been pretty good pre-season, big pre-season.
Yeah, I'm focused on getting a bit bigger tank over the summer and starting to pay dividends. And I was lucky enough to put a few on the scoreboard, mate, which is good.
Now, who is the guy that you follow? Is there anyone you look up to? I know I'm not there, so you can't look up to me, but I mean, there's got to be someone else.
Away from the playing group, probably one of your mates, Paul Lecuria.
Liquor.
He's Uncle Jimmy's own.
Actually, Liquor grabbed me by the nuts in episode one.
Can you say that? I don't think you can.
Okay, well,
as you were saying.
He's been pretty good for me. You know, he's helped me out a lot and sort of taken me from a country boy and trying to help me fit in with all the good-looking city lads, which has been good.
And did he teach you the haircut? Because I know Billy Brownless, a couple of the commentators were having a go at you about the city haircut. Yeah. You're a country boy. Well, I like the haircut. It's cool. What are they talking about?
That's it, mate. I live in St Kilda now, you know, so I've got to try and fit in. Yeah. If you got a faggy haircut, you're struggling a bit.
You're actually taller than Tony Liberatore, aren't you? So you're not the shortest bloke going around. We just want to let everyone know out there, he's not that short. Standing right next to him on the footy field, he looks that way. It might be the shorts, eh?
Well, yeah, I think it is the shorts. I've heard that Dutchie actually referred to me as a midget. Which is a little bit rough.
I think we can rewind the tapes on this.
I was having a joke, and look, I mean, I'm not that much taller than you, to be honest.
How many blokes are you going to burn?
Mates, we're good buddies. Don't worry about it. He knows I'm mucking around.
Now, mate, you come from good football stock. We actually interviewed someone from your family and found out that the football runs thick in your family. But, look, mate, before we go to that, before we let you go, we've actually got some stuff here, Brody. You've got some prizes.
Yes, we've got some prizes here for Blair. We've got the Peterworth T-shirt, we've got the Sasa security voucher, and we've got the Man What a Fuss voucher in there, too. So thanks for coming on board there today for Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room. We really appreciate it. And we've got a bit
superstar. Chop love this guy. Fair enough. Collingwood supporter, he's going to love Brody. But your cousin, Natalie Blair, neighbours superstar, acting superstar, I think she liked me, mate. I'm sorry. I think she actually liked me. Check this out. Okay, talk about Christmases coming at once. First we had Chopper, but now we've got another star of this movie, Groomless Bride, Natalie Blair. Hello, welcome to Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room.
Thanks for having me.
Now, Natalie, before we get onto the movie, well, we could actually get in a lot of trouble here because two footy players and then we've got a schoolgirl as well.
Works for me.
It could be a big story in that, Natalie. What do you think?
Now, Natalie, you've got a football background. I mean, you've got a cousin that actually plays at the moment. Tell us about him.
Jared Blair.
Now, he would come up to about there on you, doesn't he?
The midget.
The little hobbit.
He's a good midget, though.
He's been absolutely tearing it up, hasn't he? You'd be very proud of him.
It's fantastic. Yeah. I've been living overseas, so we try and get to a pub or somewhere that plays the games to support him.
Yeah.
It's hard to find.
So Groomless Bride is the name of the film that we're here for. So we better talk about that and your character. Tell us about your character and what it involves.
Well, my character's name is Sandra. And she's pretty much just obsessed with the whole romantic notion of being married and all that.
Yeah.
She gets left, she basically makes a pact with her best friends that they're all going to get married at the same church the same day, all because of an epiphany she has. Oh, long story, just going to have to watch the movie.
Yeah, I think so.
It's just about her coming to terms with herself and yada, yada, yada. Great.
Brilliant.
Obviously, she's a schoolgirl at the start, hence the outfit.
We have a few wardrobe changes. We go from the age of 15 to, I I'd say maybe 20 after 27.
So. Well, the good thing is you can play a 15-year-old and you can play a 27-year-old. So you've just got such range.
I like you.
Such range.
I was going to say that. Now I've been on
really?
That. Yeah, I did one scene on
that. Oh, my God.
You didn't hear about that.
I was probably overseas.
We'll never hear the end of this.
Live in a bubble.
He tells everyone we meet, every person we interview. I mean, you don't have to tell everyone.
Who did you work
with? I'm second.
Who did you work with, Tim?
Max Hoyland. I was actually playing myself. Yeah, I was playing myself.
It was embarrassing.
And Max Hoyland was having a dream, and I popped out of his TV set in a puff of smoke. Yeah.
Max Hoyland. What are you on? What are you doing in my kitchen, mate? The grand final's about to start.
We need a full forward, Max. And you're the man for the job.
I haven't played in years. I'm in my 40s.
I saw you having a kick down the park the other day, mate. You've still got it.
Yeah?
What?
We need you, Max. The lawyers are handling the paperwork. Mate, I haven't got any gear.
You do now, Max.
Well, what the hell are you waiting for?
I would love to be an actor. I would love to do it. It sounds like it'd be fun.
Well, why don't you?
I'm already an actor. What are you talking about?
You are. Could you teach me a thing or two, Brody?
That's what they keep saying. I reckon I'm great. No one else seems to like
it. See, you need that self-belief.
Yeah, exactly. Right. If you believe in yourself for long enough, things will happen. Isn't that right?
Absolutely.
Even if it is misguided and wrong. Well, thank you very much, Natalie, for joining us on Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room. We're so lucky to have great actors.
A kiss on the cheek, too. Rob, a kiss on the cheek.
In the school uniform.
If you're beautiful, you can't leave the set unless you get a kiss.
Well, he wanted to, but...
He is a beautiful man.
I bet you didn't ask him.
No, we didn't ask. We're too scared. Thanks very much, Natalie.
Thanks, Natalie.
Dutchie Holland, you're the worst actor of all time. I saw you interviewing Natalie Blair on Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room. You still got it.
You are kidding yourself, mate. You do it for 20 grand too. Oh. Let's get to match of the round. We've got Geelong versus Carlton. Who are you going for, buddy?
Well, I like Geelong because they knocked off your mob. They are looking the good. So, yep, for you, who are you going for?
I'm
going
to go for Geelong too. They are the best defensive side of all time up until round 9, Robbo.
Yeah, right. Well, there's the rest of our tips, no doubt you can see. Dutchie's sporting bet of the week. What you got?
I'm going the double here this week. I'm going North Melbourne into Geelong. I'm playing a little bit safe, but you get $2.64 for that, Robbo.
Right. Fresh after my win last week. The Cats got up for me. I'm going to go for the Tigers. Dreamtime at the G. $2.70 for a win. That's me.
That's you, Robbo. And we've got to introduce Uncle Jimmy's first hot reporter, Brooklyn Edwards.
Woo! Thank you, boys.
How do you feel? Congratulations, Brooklyn.
Thank you. I'm so excited. Super stoked.
Great, great. And what have you got in store for the Uncle Jimmy's team this year?
Look, I'm going to be interviewing some hot young footballers. We're going to be doing some funny skits. But look, there's too much to say. We've got a lot planned.
Right. Well, good on you guys. That's been a great show. Thanks to the Blair family. Thanks to Chopper. We'll see you next week on Uncle Jimmy's Pool Room.
Ooh, yeah, baby. Starting to like it.